Hachette Audio presents The Clarity Cleanse, 12 Steps to Finding Renewed Energy, Spiritual Fulfillment, and Emotional Healing. Written by Habib Sadeghi, D.O., FaceMip. Read by David Booth. With the foreword by Gwyneth Paltrow. Please enjoy the PDF that accompanies this audiobook. Dedication. To the memory of my brother, H. Merdad Sadeghi, M.D., and innumerable other trailblazers in the field of free thinking. Every smallest step in the field of free thinking and of the personally formed life has ever been fought for at the cost of spiritual and physical tortures. Change has required its innumerable martyrs. Nothing has been bought more dearly than that little bit of human reason and sense of freedom that is now the basis of our pride. Friedrich Nietzsche, The Day of Dawn, 1881.
Foreword by me, Gwyneth Paltrow. In his very first piece for Goop, Dr. Habib Sadeghi wrote about the truth and why it's so difficult to tell it. His wasn't the standard definition of lying. He was talking about how we have collectively been raised to prioritize politeness over personal integrity, that we have been raised to believe that skirting the truth and covering it up with white lies is a better path forward than speaking straight. He clarifies that ignoring our feelings is not only dishonest, but that refusing to honor and give voice to them is the most harmful kind of dishonesty there is. When I first started seeing Dr. Sadeghi many years ago, it was for some seemingly unrelated medical issues. But before he got to the medicine, he made me address the idea of living honestly. He believes that disease takes root when we are not living authentically and not taking care of our emotional waste. He traced what was happening in my ovaries to my thyroid, otherwise known as the throat chakra, a common source of affliction for many women who do not feel empowered to speak, who stuff and stifle emotional pain rather than speaking the truth out of their mouth. When I first met Dr. Sadeghi, I believed that honesty was a way of acting or a mindset. I now understand that it is something far deeper. It is giving yourself the space to actually feel your feelings and be true to them at all costs. Dr. Sadeghi has become a mentor in many capacities for me, though most notably for teaching me how to live in a way that is honest. It has been one of the most beautiful, painful, and interesting lessons of my life. As you will discover in this book, Dr. Sadeghi brings much clarity to every aspect of living. And with clarity comes healing.
Preface. While modern medicine has many benefits, it's clear to most of us that it also has its limits. For all the advanced technology and billions of dollars poured into research each year, our approach to illness is mostly ineffective when it comes to curing chronic diseases and neurodegenerative disorders. In fact, many diseases. While diagnostics have greatly improved over the last 60 or so years, how we end up treating the diseases we diagnose has in many ways remained essentially the same. It's clear that if healthcare is to avoid stagnation and evolve to meet the challenges of the future, in addition to the diseases we've been dealing with for more than a century, we need to think about disease differently. We must reframe our understanding of everything from what disease is and why it occurs to how we interact with it. Given our aging population and the prevalence of chronic illness, we have no choice. We simply must find a way of approaching illness that goes beyond just surgery and drugs, or our children's children will find themselves facing the same chronic killers their great-great-grandparents faced. To think in this way requires going against many of the established, institutionalized ideas we have about biology and medicine. It means we must dare to question the unquestionable. There may even be sacred cows that, at risk of being called a nutcase or quack, should be called into question, an approach that, in countless areas of medicine, proved to be the key to major advances. If medicine is to move forward, we must become trailblazers in a profession where stepping even slightly outside the accepted lines can mean the loss of one's reputation and even one's career. Still, it's a path we must tread if humanity and medicine are to progress. Without question, the catalyst behind every great discovery of human civilization, especially with regard to science and medicine, has proved to be intuition. It's the internal conviction, the inexplicable knowing, that possesses a researcher and convinces such an individual that the particle, process, energetic principle, or cure they are searching for actually exists, even in the face of no physical evidence or prior research. It's the ability to see the unseen before it becomes obvious to everyone else, along with resisting the urging of naysayers to be realistic and live within the limits of what we can experience with our senses. Only a person with an all-consuming intuitive drive and a fearless spirit can manifest the possible from the impossible and thereby change the way we experience life. Ignaz Semmelweis, a 19th-century physician, was just such a person. He firmly believed that an invisible factor, which we today commonly refer to as bacteria, was behind the deaths of thousands of expectant mothers. He insisted that the simple act of washing hands before either performing surgery or delivering babies could greatly reduce patient deaths from infection and puerperal fever. Initially, he was mercilessly humiliated by the medical establishment, even losing his job for suggesting something that's now common practice. Today, the largest university in Hungary is named after him. In the 1860s, Russian chemist Dmitri Mendeleev created the periodic table of elements, which organized all the physical building blocks of the universe into a cohesive logical order. The table included the elements gold, silver, lead, argon, neon, helium, and every other known mineral, metal, and gas at the time. While the table was incredibly helpful to science, it had a problem. Wherever Mendeleev couldn't find a transitional substance that connected two elements already on the table, he left a space between them blank. While his table worked well for certain kinds of research, his detractors were quick to point out the gaps in the chart. At that time, there were no known elements with the right atomic weights to fill those spaces and complete the chart so that it made sense. When questioned about these gaps, Mendeleev stated that while the holes in the chart did exist, it wasn't proof the corresponding elements didn't. He simply said we had to continue searching. Down to the minutest detail, Mendeleev intuited the presence of elements for which there was no tangible evidence of their existence. Today, every one of those elements has indeed been discovered, and Mendeleev's table is complete. He bequeathed to us a perfect example of how staying focused on the bigger picture and not getting hung up on the finer details is what brings a vision into being. Just because we don't have proof that something exists doesn't mean it isn't there. In 1865, German chemist Friedrich August Kekulé had a dream in which he saw atoms dancing around and linking to each other. Upon awakening, he followed his intuition and immediately sketched the image he had seen in his dream. In a further dream, he saw the atoms dance around, then form circular strings that appeared to simulate a snake eating its own tail. Instead of doubting the dream, he went with his gut instinct. Kekulé was to discover that his nighttime images were a near-perfect match for the chemical composition and cyclic nature of benzene. Semmelweis, Mendeleev, and Kekulé trusted their intuition, believed in the unseen, and were proven right. Today, there's an equally powerful and invisible force at play in chronic illness that has yet to be recognized and incorporated into treatment. That force is consciousness. Human consciousness varies from person to person, but is made up of the thoughts and feelings, both conscious and unconscious, we experience regarding everything from our job to our relationships and the world around us with respect to how we feel about ourselves. Each one of us lives within our own energetic frequency, which is self-generated by individual thoughts and feelings. It's this frequency that permeates every cell of the body and plays a major role in its physical expression, whether that be health, disease, or something in between. At the same time, our personal frequencies are interacting with the energetic frequencies of other people and even the Earth itself to create the collective energetic frequency of the planet on which all living things exist. It's this collective energy, which we all draw from and interact with, that I call the field. Like fish in the sea, consciousness moves in, around, and through us, impacting our lives every day. Not only do we interact with it, we simultaneously create it individually and collectively. It's by accessing this unseen energy through our thoughts, then charging it in either a positive or negative way based on our feelings, that we influence ourselves to develop in either healthy or diseased ways. The idea that we develop our body and create our state of health or illness from unseen energy might seem strange at first glance, until we realize that creating physical matter from unseen energy happens all around us every day. A seed placed in the earth absorbs water, germinates, and sprouts. The sprout needs nothing but invisible energy from the sun to engage in photosynthesis and the production of carbon dioxide, a gas that's also invisible, for it to grow its thin and fragile body into a massive tree. In fact, the trunk and leaves of a tree contain little of the trace minerals from the soil in which it's rooted. A tree literally creates its physical body out of thin air, using the unseen energetic forces we know exist and yet cannot experience with our senses. In much the same way, we also create our physical bodies from the invisible energy of the field. So when someone receives a medical diagnosis that informs them they have disease X, that the survival statistics are Y, and that the best treatment is Z, we're dealing only in the concrete world of physical matter, the world of effects that arise from the elements of the unseen world, which in the final analysis is the energy of the field. It stands to reason, then, that if we are to truly heal disease, we must look beyond matter and beyond individual parts to the world of energy, where thoughts and emotions created a negative frequency that eventually manifested as a diseased body. Much of the current medical world is trapped in the concrete world, the world of effects, unaware there's an entire unseen world of energy from which everything we observe is created. This leaves even the world's most brilliant researchers sometimes chasing red herrings, while all the while imagining they are going to find the cause of physical diseases in the physical world, when the reality is that the opposite is often the case. The approach is so reductionist that it continues.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.